Let's see right now how to create a perfect gravel material. First of all, it's essential to find the right textures that will characterize the material. My favorite websites to download textures from are Ambient CG and Polyeven, which have a wide selection of any materials. In this case, I refer to Polyeven and choose the material named Gravel Floor 02. The textures I download are at least 2K resolution, but if I wanted higher quality, I could also go up to 4K. The textures to download are AO, Diffuse, Displacement, Normal, and rough. Once everything is downloaded, I open DweebMotion, create a new material, and apply it to the reference surface. At this point, I assign all the textures. In color, I insert the texture diffuse for the surface color, and if needed, I change the tint and the luminosity. Then, I move to roughness, where I insert the rough texture, although in this case, it won't have much effect, and set a value just below 100%. Immediately after, in normal, I insert the respective texture, and from here the material will start to look more and more realistic. The value 100% is perfect. In the same section, I activate the parallax and insert the texture called displacement. The effect of the 3D deformations of the material is handled by the intensity slider, so I modify it as much as needed. In conclusion, in ambient occlusion, I insert the last texture, the one called AO, and set a value that satisfies me. Just keep in mind that the maximum value is not 2, but 5, to be inserted manually. The material is ready and can be saved in the user library for future use. I'd like to take just 20 seconds, I promise, to inform you that I'm creating the Twinmotion Masterclass Learning Portal, where I will guide you through the fantastic world of Twinmotion, whether you're a beginner or an expert. Click on the link in the description of this video to stay updated on all the news and secure an exclusive discount at launch. Register now using your email. Thank you so much for the support and enjoy the video. Aberration to the gravel material is a set of 3D models of stones or pebbles. In the Twinmotion library, there are no such small 3D models of stones. So, I open Megascan, 3D Assets, Nature, Rock, Scatter, and filter the search by pack. I select a pack of stones, import it into the scene, scale it just enough, and save it to the user library. At this point, I activate the scatter tool, insert the newly saved pack into the scatter box a dozen times, select all the individual 3D models, and repeatedly click on the relevant surface to fill it with gravel. For more expansion, I can redo the same procedure a couple of times. The method I just showed you is definitely better from a quality point of view than using, of course, a single material. But it is also true that this method weighs down the Twinmotion file a lot. I suggest you to use it sparingly. Thank you so much for watching this video. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future content. Like the video so you can help me with the algorithm. And suggest me in the comment section what topic you would like me to cover in the next video. That said, I wish you a good day or evening and see you very soon. Ciao!